5 News.
4:15 on your Thursday afternoon. We're almost to the weekend, and those temperatures will continue to climb. You can see on our First Alert Live Super Doppler Max, the low country's most powerful Doppler radar, we're seeing mostly clear skies out there. Still watching that coastal disturbance that brought a little moisture right off along our coastline, but mostly dry today, and that will be the name of the game, dry and warm. Notice off in the distance, though, we will be keeping a close eye on a cold front that will start to approach our area, which could bring a very slight chance for a shower on Saturday. Otherwise, we're looking pretty good over the next few days. Take a look at our future tracker for today if you have to step outside at all, and not much is going to change for you. So if you like what you see outside right now, you'll continue to love the rest of our evening. Even as you go to your social hour, maybe you're going out to dinner tonight, dancing, movies, whatever you have planned, yoga class, it's going to be a really nice night for it. Even 11 o'clock, not seeing much out there. Overnight, however, we will start to see the development of some patchy to dense fog in some spots. So just be mindful of that if you have to drive overnight or early tomorrow morning. Taking a look at these temperatures, though, notice that you just continue to climb. We've got 75 for you right now in North Charleston. Somerville has cooled down a little bit now, down to 73. We've got 75 in Goose Creek, 73 Monk's Corner. Pretty much low to mid 70s, depending on where you are. Folly Beach right now, you are in the upper 60s. So what to expect over the next few hours? We will be dropping the majority of us into the upper 60s by about 6 o'clock, lower 60s by 70. Clear skies, winds will start to calm a bit, and of course with those clear skies we will cool down to 52. Not a huge jump there. So 37 again, that's where we should be for those overnight lows this time of year, but 52 is where we'll sit. Clear, calm, but the patchy fog that will come later on. So just be mindful of that again if you have to be out overnight or early tomorrow morning. Might want to give yourself a little extra time to drive just in case. 78 for us tomorrow, and that actually was the original record back in 1960. So we might be tying that record, maybe even breaking it, something that we'll have to continue to watch for you. Notice we should be in the upper 50s this time of year for that daytime high. We're going to see plenty of sunshine once again tomorrow. So if you have outdoor plans or you work outdoors, just make sure you have plenty of water because it's going to be a lot warmer than we should be for this time of year, but a beautiful day nonetheless. And look at it over the next 3 days. Not a huge change. We do cool 10 degrees as we go into Saturday because of that cold front I mentioned with a slight chance of a shower. But notice we start to warm back up for Sunday. So will that warming continue once we go into the next work week? That's something you'll have to stay tuned for in our full forecast coming up with our chief meteorologist Bill Walsh at 5 o'clock. So don't miss that. We've got more for you. Let's get to First Alert traffic, though, with an update before you step outside. And things have been really good for the most part, with the exception of the Ravenel Bridge. And notice we're also starting to see some backup here along the Don Holt. But let me zoom in. That traffic accident has been cleared going southbound on the Ravenel. Notice Ravenel speeds are down to, or up to, I should say, 57 miles per hour. But as you get closer to Mount Pleasant, we're seeing stop-and-go traffic 10 miles per hour. So just something to be mindful of if you have to leave Mount Pleasant and head to Charleston. Taking a look at those drive times right now, westbound lanes of I-526 are pretty slow. Mount Pleasant to West Ashley will take you about 43 minutes to get there. Then as we take a look at I-26, 19 minutes eastbound, 22 minutes southbound. That's downtown to Somerville. And here's a look at Highway 17 right now. Numbers are starting to improve, of course, with the clearing of that accident. We'll have more updates coming up at 5 o'clock.